making a million, being the illest hustler that the world ever seen. He used to fuck movie stars and sniff coke in his dreams. A corrupted young mind at the age of 13. Nigga never had a father and his mom was a fiend. She put the pipe down, but for every year she was sober. Her son's heart simultaneously grew colder. Started hanging out, selling bags in the project, checking the young chicks, looking for hand for prospects. He was fascinated by material objects, but he understood money never bought respect. He built a reputation cause he could hustle and steal, but got locked once and didn't hesitate to squeal. Criminals he chill with didn't think he was real. See, me and niggas like this have never been equal. I don't project my insecurities on other people. You're fiending for props like addicts with pipes and needles. So he felt he had to prove to everyone he was evil. A feeble-minded young man with infinite potential, the product of a ghetto-bred capitalistic mental. Coincidentally dropped out of school to sell weed, dancing with the devil, smoked until his eyes don't bleed. But he was sick of selling trees and gave into his greed. Gotta tell you about my homie right here. So Billy started robbing niggas anything he could do. He'd get his respect back in the eyes of his crew. Starting fights over little shit off on the block. Stepped up to selling mothers and brothers to crack rock. Working overtime, making money for the crack spot. Hit the jackpot and wanted to move up to cocaine. The villain of Scarface fantasy stuck in his brain. Tired of them hood niggas treating him the same. He wanted to be major like the cutthroats and the thugs. But when he tried to step to him, niggas showed him no love. He told him any motherfucking caliber could sell drugs. Any bitch nigga with a gun can bust love. Any nigga with a red shirt can front like a blood. Even Puffy smoked the motherfucker up in the club. But only a real thug would stab someone to they die. Standing in front of them, staring straight into their eyes. Billy realized that these men were well guarded, and they wanted to test him before business started. Suggested raping a chick to prove he was cold-hearted. Now he had a choice between going back to his life or making money with made men up in his sight. His dreams about cars and ice made him a creed. A hardcore nigga is all he ever wanted to be. So he met them Friday night at 2:45. Let's take this ride, my dude, come on. Project slow while he was raining, smoking blunts, drinking and joking for entertainment. Till they saw a woman on the street walking alone, 3 in the morning coming back from work all the way home. So they quietly got out the car and followed her, walking through the projects, the darkness swallowed her. Wrapped a shirt around her head and knocked her onto the floor. This is it, kid, now you got your chance to be wrong. So Billy yoked her up and grabbed the chick by the hair, dragged her into a lobby that had nobody there. Struggled hard, but they forced her to go up the stairs. Got to the roof and then they held her down on the ground, yelling, shut the fuck up, stop moving around. Her shirt covered her face, but she screamed and clawed. Billy stomped on a bitch till he broke in a jaw. Them dirty bastards knew exactly what they were doing. They kicked her until they cracked the ribs and she stopped moving. Blood leaking through the floor, she cried silently. And then they all proceeded to rape her violently. Billy was made to go first, but each of them took a turn, ripping her up and choking her until the throat burned. Her broken jaw moment forgot, but they weren't concerned. When they were done and she was lying bloody, broken and bruised, one of them niggas pulled out a brand new 22. He told them that she was a witness for what she gone through. And if he killed her, he was guaranteed to spot the crew. He thought about it for a minute, she's practically dead. So he leaned over and put the gun right to her head. Now I have to finish my story for her. And it can only end like this. Right before he pulled the trigger and ended her life, he thought about the cocaine with the platinum and ice. And he felt strong standing along with his new brother. Cocked the cat to her head and pulled back the shirt cover. But what he saw made him start to cringe and stutter, cause he was staring into the eyes of his own mother. She looked back at him and cried cause he had forsaken her. She cried more painfully, and when they were raping her, his whole world stopped. He couldn't even contemplate. His corruption had successfully changed his fate. And he remembered how his moms used to come home late, working hard for nothing, cause now what was he worth? He turned away from the woman that had once given him birth and cried out to the sky cause he was lonely and scared. But only the devil responded cause God wasn't there. And right then he knew what it was to be empty and cold. So he jumped off the roof and died with no soul. They say death takes you to a better place, but I doubt it. After that they killed his mother and never spoke about it. And listen, cause the story that I'm telling is true, cause I was being with Billy Jacobs and I wrapped his mom too. Now the devil follows me everywhere that I go. In fact, I'm sure he's standing among one of you in my shows. And every street cypher listening to Lil Thug Slow. Could be standing right next to you and you wouldn't know. The devil grows inside the hearts of the selfish and wicked. White, brown, yellow, and black color is not restricted. You have a self-destructive destiny when you're inflicted. And every one of God's children and fell for the top. There's no diversity. wants to be